Let me start off with John. John, you have one of the most unusual theories, and it's regarding Michael Jackson, all right?
Yes.
I understand that you actually consider him a threat to our civilization. Now, as far as I can tell, he's only a threat to the elephant man.
First, I want to make clear, Mort, that I'm not here speaking for the Washington Times, and I appreciate your giving me this time to simultaneously apologize to Michael Jackson and call for his deportation. He should be deported for three reasons. And he has three problems, and he can't be let back in until they're solved. The first problem is the sex problem, the problem being we don't know what sex he is.
Well, is that we don't know? What difference does it make if we know as long as he knows?
Or, to put it in the words of a popular song on MTV now, the dude looks like a lady. The second problem is he should not be allowed to re-enter this country until he gets a real job. Now, the third point is arguably the most serious one, and that has to do with his third problem. I don't know exactly how to describe it even on this show other than to say he should not be allowed back in this country until we're sure that what he has, that the rest of us cannot get it. Now, I'm talking about Tarantism. Yeah, what?
Tarantism?
Well, see, that's the first thing
all right,
I said.
See, we don't know what that
when
is.
I heard about
I thought
the
that
dictionary.
Was raw steak or something.
Wrong. Tarantism, the dictionary describes it as a nervous affection characterized by an uncontrollable impulse.
An affection or an affliction?
Affection.
Oh.
Caused by an uncontrollable impulse to dance, especially prevalent in Italy from the 15th to the 17th century.
Now, this is important stuff, yeah, folks. I mean, we might be getting a breakthrough.
By the way,
here.
You call this a... you call this a theory, Mort. This is a fact. This is not a theory.
Well, it's a fact. All right.
This dancing mania... Just let me finish the definition. This dancing mania is popularly attributed to the bite of the tarantula.
Ah.
Now, just one other quick point, and it's a factual point. I was skeptical about this, too. I laughed like you laughed. And then I ran across the October 1963 issue of the Bulletin of the History of Medicine, published by the Johns Hopkins University.
That sounds like a must-read.
Was an article titled An Historical and Socio-Psychiatric Appraisal of Tarantism and Its Importance in the Tradition of Psychotherapy of Mental Disorders. I'm just going
to
give you one little bit of this.
On the toilet, huh?
Some of the... You know, if Dave Clark can walk off this show, I can do it too.
But you're too much of a man.
Well, that's precisely why I won't. The symptoms of this Tarantism, I read in this article, it didn't sound like Michael Jackson until I got to this part. The person who was bitten by the tarantula would sing, touch parts of his body supposedly bitten by the spider, especially his hands, feet, and genitals. Now, have you seen the video Bad? Have you seen the video?
I don't know. Run the monitor out here so the folks in the audience can see it. And folks, I've seen the video Bad. I just don't look for Michael Jackson to be, you know, I mean, I see the dancing. I don't, you know.
Yeah. It's everywhere.
Huh?
He's
everywhere?
Bitten all over. I think he's bitten all over.
Bitten all over. Let's see Michael Jackson dancing to Bad. Let's see. Now, wait a second, John. Let me understand this. I saw that. I saw him a couple times go like that. All right, wait a second. Wait a second. That means Dave Winfield was bitten by spiders? All right? That means Ken Mattingly was bitten by spiders? All right, wait a second. Wait a second. Wait a second. And, John, that means I was bitten by spiders. All right?
You have, if you'll pardon the expression, put your finger precisely on the problem. This is something that's spreading in this country. Of course Dave Winfield may have it. You may have it. This is one reason for why he ought to be deported. Now, I want to say one other thing.
this is not something that I rushed into. This is something that I've thought about. When Michael Jackson wanted to buy the elephant person's, I guess we have to say, bones, I didn't want to deport him. When he wanted to build a shrine to Elizabeth Taylor, I didn't want to deport him. When I read in the National Enquirer that he goes over to the little guy on Webster and ties towels around their necks, they fly around like Superman, I didn't want to deport him. I didn't even want to deport him when he wanted to talk to his chimpanzee, his pet.
You have a dog?
Sort of.
You ever talk to them? Huh? You ever talk to them? You know, like, here, pussy. Here, pussy.
A dog?
Huh?
A dog?
My dog's name is Pussy. Let me come to Dick Carter a second. Dick, now, you've listened to this bizarre theory of Mr. Lofton's. You feel you're in the high-risk category of contracting Tarantism? Tarantism? I've noticed you've got your hands cupped just in case you get bit.
Well, Morton, I tell you, I don't really know what to think about this. It is unusual and unique, the things he says. I happen to enjoy Michael Jackson. I think he's a great artist, and I think the video bad, and all of his recordings are great. And
it's real art.
I think John Lofton's theory is dog.
Well, I mean, that's as straightforward as you can get. Why do you have your hands folded there? You're not going to get bit.
You know why I know it isn't that. Because
why?
If it was, you'd be for it.
Well, I think you're a little misguided there because
really?
You don't...
Have you done the research on Tarantism? Have you done any reading about Tarantism?
You don't know me, Jack.
Have you done
so
any
don't tell me what
Tarantism?
I'm going to do.
Have you done any reading about Tarantism?
Can you dig it?
Have you done
can
any
you
reading?
Read?
Have you done any reading?
Can you read?
You can't read.
You can't read.
Hey. You've read zero. You've read
you know
nothing
what?
About
you know
Tarantism.
What?
Nothing.
You know what?
You can just use and a foul mouth.
You
That's
look,
why you like Michael
you
Jackson.
Look like
you're
a jerk.
Bad.
You
you're
look like
bad,
a jerk.
No.
If you're going to grow a Mr. beard, Gutterman. Grow a proper no. beard. Martin, speaking of pets and dogs and cats, you look like something the cat dragged in, Jack.
Do you have anything of substance to say, or is your whole attack to just attack me personally?
I'm not
Can
attacking.
Can you say anything of substance?
I'm not attacking.
Oh, really?
No, I'm reacting.
I see. Do you have anything?
Morton asked me a question.
Well, all you've done is cursed. Do you have anything intelligent to
say? I haven't cursed except one time.
I see. Well, it was one too many. Why did you
do that? Let me tell you something,
my friend.
You
ought to have your mouth washed
out
with soap, you know that?
I'm going to wash out your mouth with
you.
Shine
my shoe.
Shine
mine,
boy.
Shine
mine, boy.
I'm not going to punch anybody.
Oh, I'm going to punch you.
No, you're not. No,
you're not even worth punching.
Yeah, that's what
you're
I thought.
You're not even worth punching.
You're all
get
mouth.
Him, get
you,
him
gang,
back to Michael Jackson.
You know me. I can't stand violence. I want to go to Mr. Ellis, all right? Mr. Ellis, let me go to you now.
John.
Question. Steve.
Hands right here, John.
Steve, you're a music programmer,
right.
All right, at one of the top rock stations in the country. Has your experience with Michael Jackson led you to believe that he's a poor example for the youth of America?
No, he's a good... John, hands right here, okay? Right up here, the whole time.
Okay, but I saw where they were before.
Yeah, uh-huh. You know, Michael Jackson has probably done more for the youth of America than anybody else in the country. Given more money, wrote USA for Africa, has donated a hospital wing at Mount Sinai, and probably done more than you'll ever think about doing for America and underprivileged people.
Is that right?
Well, I noticed that you're very cleverly avoiding the Tarantism issue.
The guy likes to dance, John. What do you like to do in your spare time?
Nothing.
What do you like to do?
What do I like to do?
Yeah. Shave, obviously, is not one of them.
What's that?
Shaving is not one of them, right?
You're probably just jealous because you can't grow a beard.
Yeah.
I mean, on his chin. But how about the Tarantism issue? How about addressing the issue? You seem to be making the point that if he builds enough hospitals and gives away enough money, he has a right to infect the country with this disease. Is that your point?
I think you have no facts that says that he has a disease of any kind like that.
Oh, you think Michael Jackson's normal, huh? What sex is he?
He's a little more normal than you, probably.
What is his sex? Do you know? What is Michael Jackson's sex?
He is a male.
How do you know that?
He is a male. He's
How do you
a male.
Know that?
What are you, John?
How do you know that? Margot!
John, what are you wearing?
Margot, let me hear
he's
some
floundering.
Music. Let me hear bad. See if it infects me.
It's not the music.